Hello everybody, I'm Storm here, and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4, the Kingdom of Greece. In the last episode, we continued our push north through Central America, and we are continuing that work. We were able to take out Costa Rica, and we are now justifying a war goal against Nicaragua. In an effort to push through there, then we'll have to knock over Honduras and Guatemala. So that project is moving pretty well. We had some significant fighting going on in Ontario. The Americans had basically formed a salient pushing toward Toronto in an effort to cut off a pocket here. But we were able to basically hold them back. And then we were able to do a envelopment by cutting them off. And we were able to destroy a rather sizable chunk of the American military. I think it was somewhere in upwards of 60 divisions we were able to destroy. But even so, it still hasn't really helped all that much. I mean, and it's largely because the German AI has been doing something really weird, where they've been basically pulling all their forces back here. I mean, they've got 92 divisions sitting right there and not keeping them on the front. And as a result, we've lost Detroit. We have the American Army pushing through Ontario here. We've set up a defensive line here to try to hold them back and keep them from taking Toronto. And we'll have to see if any opportunity presents itself to counterattack again. But we are pretty much just in a holding action here, trying to make sure that the Americans don't break out and take out our armies up here while we work our way through to Central America down here, and hopefully are at some point able to take out Mexico and open up this front, which is what the end goal is. Alright, let me just look at things here. The fleet is still undergoing repairs. A lot of ships are actually almost ready to go, so hopefully we'll be able to get our fleet back in action sometime soon. Oh, and it looks like we've got 5 new infantry divisions. That's interesting. What I would like to do is get those guys to Europe. Not Europe. To South America. So, can I have those guys come in there? That would be good. Also, the other thing I noticed here, we've got some more garrison units. And in fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a new garrison force here. I'm going to keep its color black. Actually, I might Yeah, that's fine. And I need to get it over into South America to start garrisoning our holdings. So you guys need to head down here. And then we'll get those over where they need to be. Alright, so let's go ahead and unpause it. Let's get guys moving here. Now I was also looking at this, and it looks like we've actually got some more units with enough material to actually train, so that is good. In fact, all of these infantry divisions are at 100% equipment. So that is very good. Because we definitely could use some more troops in the field. Alright, so the Americans have been content to just hold this line, and hopefully they will remain content to hold this line. Hopefully that we're going to be able to hold this, and hopefully the Germans then decide to do something here. with all the troops they've gathered here. They've got 120 divisions. Just sitting there. What on earth are they doing? We've got no fronts. No fronts. Anywhere. This is the first time I've ever seen anything really egregiously weird with the way the AI works. So... Alright, when's our war justification with Nicaragua going to be done? June 27th, so a little over a month. Alright, I've got these guys, 18 divisions down here. I've got these guys ready to go when needed. But what I actually want to do is... I want to get infrastructure built up. And I want to get a port built up here as well. In fact, I'm going to push those to the top. Make sure that gets done. Because we're going to need this pathway to supply our troops. So, I've got these 19 Marine divisions as well. Is there any way I can park them somewhere closer? I think I can, actually. Alright, you guys, redeploy over here. Now, how are we looking over here? We're looking okay. We've been able to hold so far. Haven't been able to make any headway, but at least they've been able to hold. Let them move in. Okay, so now that they've taken that, what we're going to do is we're going to adjust this to have you guys, instead of sitting on a fallback line, I'm actually going to give them a front. Wow. That's not what we want to do. I'm going to give them the front here. With an actual battle plan to push back to Detroit. I'm gonna give you guys a battle plan as well. Just to start queuing up some... some planning bonus. Okay, well, they're poking me here. But not making any headway. Not yet, anyway. I've got 50 submarines. Ooh. Okay. We probably can cool our jets on those subs for now. I'll have to decide what I can do with those. I can send them out to patrol the Atlantic. Or I could bring them into the Pacific. Some free dockyards. Let's take a look. Let's put them in the convoys. They're actually waiting for this carrier to finish, and then once that carrier finishes, we're going to put all those dockyards onto that carrier. So we've got these new infantry divisions. Hopefully they don't run into any American ships. Alright, now these garrison divisions. Same thing, I want them to come in here. Let's see. It appears that everybody is back up to full strength with the fleet. Okay, so let's actually bring the fleet back down. We're working on building this up to level 10. Let's bring the fleet down here. Now, what's the air situation look like? They've still got some significant amounts of planes over the Caribbean. What have I got down here? 2,000 of my own fighters. Naval bombers. Transports. I'm gonna get rid of the transports. Some more fighters. Take control of the Caribbean Sea. That sounds like a good idea. Yep, they started throwing some of their own planes up here to counteract mine. How many fighters do I actually have in reserve? About 1,000 fighters in reserve. I'm not even sure where they would have an air base. They'd be within range. Maybe here? Nope, those are just naval bases. Alright, we shot down one of their aces. Still waiting on that. Let's actually speed things up a little bit. Okay, well, they have dramatic numerical superiority over here. But so far, they're just holding. These guys are saying that they can win this fight? Inferior enemy 100%. Estimated plan value. Really? Looks like the Germans are finally spreading out, doing something. Oh, they've reestablished a front. Oh, infantry anti-tank weapons 2. One thing I really need to do is I need to improve my Marines. And yeah, they may be able to push on this. Like, if I launch the attack here, did it support like that? I could definitely push that back. Imperial ambitions. Current developments considered it would be out of this world for us to consider restoring our once glorious empire. We gain claims on a bunch of stuff. Okay. Anything else we can take? I guess I can take the island infrastructure. Couldn't hurt. And we'll keep working on those convoys. And they keep moving units in there. And we keep throwing them back. Eventually my guys will get in there. Yep, and they are. Oh, free civilian factories. Let's go with more military factories. Enemy has air superiority. What? No. How goes the fight over the Caribbean? Pretty well so far. Over the last month, or last 12 months. We've lost 497 fighters. We've shot down 667 of theirs. Are we able to keep up? Looks like we are able to actually keep up with the losses, so that's good. We're actually green across the board. That is beautiful. That is what I like to see. Alright, can you guys, if you guys launch an attack here, will that go in my favor? It doesn't look like it. Back off. Escort carriers. Okay, so let's see here. We need some more naval bases. Or shipyards, I should say. Let's get those built up. We also... let's finish this. Let's go with the submarine offensive. Get our submarine doctrines fully filled out, so that hopefully our subs will perform a lot better than they have been. Okay, so, we've got our units over here. So you guys... I actually want them to attach to this front. Good. They're deploying over. And these guys... need to garrison... over here. We've got our fleet. We're now up to 6 aircraft carriers. Six battleships, including 2 super heavies, 11 heavy cruisers, 15 light cruisers, and 17 destroyers. And I actually have a whole bunch more destroyers kicking over here. Well, it's like 10 more destroyers, but they're protecting the coast over there. Let's go ahead and get these guys back out in the Caribbean patrolling. Well, as long as the Germans keep their forces out on the front, we should be okay. We should be able to hold them back. Alright, it's 21st of May. Nuclear bombs. Ooh. That's big. Okay. Let's go with experimental rockets. We actually need to start working on this because we need to get the jets. Let's see. Free dockyards. That hasn't finished yet. So let's see. Nuclear bombs. Total reactors built 5. Total production speed 1.3% per day. Next nuclear bomb is going to be ready in roughly 71 days. Alright. Now, the thing is, we need strategic bombers, which I actually haven't even researched strategic bombers yet. And you also need air superiority over the target in order to be able to drop the bomb. So, that's going to be interesting. But if I could bleed some of their fighters dry over here, that'd be good. And we do need to start working on that. So when's something you can get done? Excavation 3? 13 days? And we lost a few carrier fighters. That's okay. So those divisions are in there now. And let me look at my recruitment. Oh, we have 6 more infantry divisions. We have 7 more armored divisions. 3 more mechanized. Okay. Where could I put those guys? Those are motorized. Where are you guys? Sitting there. Do we have stockpiles of mechanized? No, we're still way behind on mechanized. Well, not way behind, but we're behind on mechanized. But here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna get all these guys over here. We're gonna fill in this southern front. Alright, so you guys get marching over, or sailing over here. These tanks get to a port. These guys get to a port as well. Alright, so then those guys come over here. And these guys come over here as well. And then we'll sort out where we're gonna put them. How are we looking? We're looking okay. These guys still say that they are... they have an advantageous plan. So that these guys... I don't want to risk going on the offensive. Not yet. Not until I've knocked over Mexico and have a second front. And more free civilian factories. Looks like we're able to get that infrastructure built. That's good. Let's go with more synthetic refineries. Let's actually build them here. And free dockyards. July 13th is when that carrier is going to be done. I'm just reminding myself here, June 27th. Okay, so... oh, excavation 3. So what we really need to do is we need to start getting to work on strategic bombers. So... because if we are going to engage in... nuclear attacks, we're going to need strategic bombers. Alright, we're 30% towards our first nuke. I have no idea how I'm going to attain any kind of air superiority where there are going to be targets I'm going to want to hit. Trying to see... there's any... ooh, super heavy battleship 2s. Don't want to go with battle cruisers. At all. I don't really see any need for battle cruisers. So no, we're going to ignore the battlecruisers. Instead, I am going to get to work on... actually, let's go with his encryption. There's one thing that's been giving the Americans an advantage. So we'll see if we can work on eliminating that advantage. Let's build some more factories. More factories. Continue work on those convoys. Alright, and these guys are on their way. We've got some more infantry. That's good, that's good. It might be worth moving my fleet up here and trying to gain control of the sea zones over here so that I can start bringing some reinforcements into the north. Free military factories. Let's see, what do we want to do? Where are we still suffering issues? Mechanized? Medium tanks. Medium tanks. Oh, we're making mechanized ones. Might want to switch that up to mechanized twos, even though that's going to impact production. Should be alright. Actually, let's just put these in here. We're going to do a medium tank destroyers. Continue work on those. Alright, so we should almost be done our war goal here. Indeed we are. Alright, let's go ahead and declare that war. Call our allies in. You guys go ahead and execute your attack. Should be fully planned. They shouldn't be able to withstand our assault. And actually what I'm going to go ahead and do is just immediately start justifying on Honduras. If we run into a problem, we can always cancel it. More dockyards. Actually, let's just slow things down a tad there. Oh, hold on. We finished that carrier. There we go. Counterattacking? I guess they are. Infrastructure finished, and experimental rockets finished as well. Alright, so it looks like the last thing we can really take is fortify Epirus, which we might as well do. And let's continue work on our rocket engines. Interesting way they're moving about this. Oh, we lost one of our aces. Okay. Holy moly, they put a lot of planes out here. Are we able to keep up? Hmm. Well, according to the numbers, we're okay. I guess they couldn't move into there. Oh, we're at maximum air experience. Ah, so let's do something with that. Let's take our fighters. We're running two runs of fighters. And let's create a variant of our fighter threes. Increase the reliability, of course. Get them some better weapons, some better engines. Seeing a little bit more range. Yes. Mark 1s. Let's switch both these over to Mark 1s. That did dip our production a little bit, but it will get better fighters to our pilots. More reliable, so he won't take as many mechanical losses. Yep, this is just a matter of time. And actually, couldn't I... Oh, we need to build up our infrastructure here. Have these guys arrived? Yes, they have. Alright, you guys, get on this front. And... we're gonna put mechanized infantry into this army. And actually, we're gonna bring those guys over here. Armor. We'll put into this army. And we're going to redeploy those guys over here. Yep, there we go. And we've got 7 more mechanized infantry divisions. Very nice. What I'm thinking I'm going to do is I'm going to take my... submarines. And I'm going to move them to Quebec. They're going to try and get some reinforcements up here. Alright, but we are actually very long on this episode. So we are going to end this here. We should be taking out Nicaragua here momentarily. Then we'll go up against Honduras. And we actually appear to be in a fairly good position at the moment. So things are moving in a positive direction. All right, well, hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Go ahead, like, subscribe, and comment. And I will see you next time.